equestrian friends. Today I want to talk to you guys about grazing muzzles. Yay! Bucky, your favorite thing! So, if you couldn't tell, we live in a very lush grass field, and it has turned my wonderful buckskin into a golden hippo. Sorry, I'm being distracted by kitty cats. Oh, kitty cat says hi. To turn this beach sea mammal back to a wonderful fit land mammal, we're going to talk about grazing muzzles. So I've tried the typical normal grazing muzzle. I even got the kind that's supposed to be more breathable. This is the normal typical one that's very dirty, that has the single hole and it's got more room for their nostrils to breathe. And he did seem to like this type better than the typical one that's like this all the way around. This lasted for a couple of weeks and then he figured out how to get it off. And he actually started to become difficult to catch while he was wearing this, which he's never been that way. He's always walked right up to me, never had a problem catching until I started putting this on, and then he was like, okay, see you, bye, Mom. Even though I would put it on in his stall as he ate and not out in the field, he still became kind of hard to catch. I'm terribly sorry, this cat's like rubbing all over the camera tripod. Oh, he wants so much attention. So that was kind of a bust, kind of a waste of $40. So we quit doing the grazing muzzle altogether. I've been riding Buck at least 4 to 5 times a week, and he is still a big fat chunky monkey. You can't blame him with all this grass we got going on. So I just purchased this grazing muzzle. This is the GreenGuard grazing muzzle. So I got the muzzle and the matching halter in this nice cool lime green color. I think green is a cool color for Buck. It looks really good on him. And also, if he were to lose it out in the field, bright colors might be easier to find, even though all the grass is this color, but we'll see. It also comes in bright raspberry and black. The reason I wanted to get a bright color instead of a black color is this can get really hot and absorb the heat, and in Alabama it's like 100 degrees. So I decided to get this, which should be a lot cooler, and just by holding it compared to the other muzzle, it actually feels cooler to the touch. The other muzzle, you could actually feel it was already kind of holding on to some heat. This is worlds lighter than that heavier muzzle, and there's also multiple holes for them to graze out of, although the way that it smishes the grass down, they still can't get more grass than the standard one hole, but they don't feel as restricted with this. Their halter is pretty cool. It's also this lime green color, but it has this strap that goes in the front to keep them from rubbing it off and wearing it like a necklace. Then it has very sturdy clips and keepers that are metal, so this part's very sturdy. It's got, this is a breakaway leather, so if they were to get hung on something, this would break away. But the cool thing about them is it's lined with fleece. I don't know if you can see that, if the cat would quit knocking my camera. Oh my god, cat, stop, go away. So it's lined with fleece so that you don't have to ghetto rig your own fleece onto there to prevent it from rubbing their hair off. So I really like that. And then also the nose band is lined with fleece and it's stitched in there. You can see the green stitches there. It is a double layer nylon with the fleece, so it seems like a pretty nice sturdy halter. And then I'm not sure how well you can see it, but that strap that goes in between their eyes in front of their face, it actually connects to the crown piece. Oh my god, cat, stop. My cat is like attacking the tripod. It actually connects in the center here to where it won't slide from side to side, so it'll stay down the center. And then it also has a connection point here that is lined with fleece so it won't rub at all. It came with these straps. So there's 4 straps that hook on. And they said if you do have a big Houdini horse, you can also put a strap from here to here in the corner and make 8 connection points as opposed to the 4 connection points. And then last but not least, it's got this really cool, so this is like the chin strap, and it is adjustable to make it tighter or looser around their chin as you see fit. So pretty cool. I'm excited to go try it out. Let's go try it out on Buck. These are their feed stalls, and Buck hardly gets any grain at all because he's so fat. So here's kind of a before shot of how he looks, and then I'll do an after shot maybe after about a month of wearing this muzzle without any big changes to his exercise routine, but he just gets enough grain to take his supplements with, so you can see how big and chunky his butt is. And he's starting to kind of get fat pads, which worries me. Did a good cleavage shot. Yep. You're ready, chunker monkers. Hey, kitty cat. His neck isn't too crusty, thankfully, but we need to stop it before it gets there. So everything is fully adjustable. This is fully adjustable. This chin strap is fully adjustable, which I really like. You can adjust this. You can even adjust the ties that they give you. Initial reaction, not a really big fan, but he really hated his old muzzle. So, I think it fits fairly well. We'll see how he does. My one concern with this strap is it might rub his forelock. So we'll just have to see. I don't know if I should braid his forelock up or what. But that's really my only big concern, is just that rubbing his forelock funny. Yeah, you want to get turned out, see how you like it? So even around here is fully adjustable, but I think that that's a pretty good fit. I moved this down a little bit. So let's see how you like it. So he's rubbing it on the ground. I think trying to figure out if he can get it off or not. Alright, we figured out that we can eat with it on. And it's much easier to drink from. Isn't that right, Becky? You don't have to shove your whole nose in there to drink out of like the other one. Yeah. See, it's not so bad. Good boy. Yeah, it's not so bad. We're coming around to it. Okay guys, it's been about an hour later. His normal muzzle he would have dumped by now. Let's see if he still has this one on. It's still on! Yay, that's so promising. So he's pretty far away from me right now, but the cool thing about him having that nice lime green color is I can easily see if he still has it on or not. So far so good, so far impressed. We'll see if he keeps it on in the morning.
Oh, look what handsome man still has on his face. It's almost 24 hours later. Hey, buddy. You want a little break from it? We can take it off. Hi. Oh, you did so good.
He's going to get a cookie for keeping that on. It's pretty easy to feed cookies through it. Oh, can you find it in that basket? Don't drop your cookie. Yeah. So I meant to actually come out in the morning and take it off and just let him wear it for about 12 hours, but I have to be at clinical by 6 o'clock in the morning. So that means I have to leave here no later than 5:15, and I just didn't wake up in time to do it. And I thought a little extra time wouldn't hurt. I wanted to see if he'd keep it on, and he did. Literally, it's been 20 hours. He's kept this on. Oh, you did so good, buddy. It wasn't so bad. It's nice and light and cool. He's not all sweaty, and it's hot today. So he's been in like 100 degree heat today and not sweaty at all. His older muzzle, I know, we're gonna take it off and you can have a break. His old muzzle, he would get so hot and sweaty. His whole face would be sweaty, and there's not any bit of sweat on him at all. He did so good. There's a little bit of sweat on his ears. That's just from wearing the halter. These rub marks he already had. He got into a little bit of a scuffle with a friend's horse at a horse show over the fence, sticking their heads over the fence. So that is not in regards to the muzzle at all. The muzzle did not make those scuff marks. He already had those little scuff marks on his face. So there's no new scuff marks at all. We only have a little bit of sweat behind the ears. No sweat on the muzzle. He seems pretty happy to stick with me. Before, when he had to wear that hot, sweaty, gross muzzle, he would run to me to get it off, and then he'd be like, okay, see ya, bye. Oh, he has a scratchy spot. And he's always been the puppy dog kind of personality.
And when he had to wear the gross heavy muzzle, he did not really want to be with me. So I'm hoping that this muzzle will be better. Super, super, super impressed so far.
Yay! So it's been, I don't know, maybe a week, and Buck's worn it a handful of times, like 5 times. He's kept it on really well. The only place I've noticed that it started to rub is behind his chin right here, just a little tiny spot where it rubs. And I've tried to position it differently. It's just Buck has this huge bulbous chin in the back. And on their website, it does say that some horses have a little bit of trouble with that. And to fix that, they say to put some tape on the back. So as you can see, this thing's like one big basket. And I think that his chin was just kind of rubbing on these holes right here. Instead of doing tape, I have done vet wrap. I thought maybe the vet wrap would be a little softer and it would maybe stay on a little better. I thought about putting fleece back there on the back, but I was like, well, when he drinks, the fleece will get all wet and gross and take a while to dry out. So I'm gonna try the vet wrap and see how that does.
Where he's rubbed just a little tiny spot, but look how bulbous his chin is. He's got just this really big bulbousy chin. He says, don't talk to me that way. How offensive. I think just as he chewed, his chin was just rubbing against the holes back here.
So I kept it on for another 8 hours, and it kind of looks like the vet wrap might have rubbed it a little more. So I think I'm gonna give him a few days break, let this heal up, put some ointment on it, and then probably try out the fleece and see how the fleece does on the back.
Kept it on really good. Looks like that all stayed on nice. Here, you get that off. Hang on, Bubby. I'm coming. It's hard to do all this with one hand.
No more rubs. Oop. That looks good.
I think the felt is going to work out. It just, the only problem is it gets kind of gross and wet because it's down there on the muzzle where he drinks and where the grass gets wet. So I'll just have to keep a close eye on it, hang it up. Hopefully it'll dry out pretty good. Might have to change it out more frequently than the felt you put up on top of halters. But overall, I'm really, really happy with it. He keeps it on, so that is the biggest plus. And he doesn't seem to mind it too terribly much, although it's not his favorite. And check him out, he's already looking better. It's been about 2 weeks of use so far. And he kind of has a contour there. He's still pretty pudgy in the back, but he is a quarter horse, so that might not ever go away. But his fat deposits kind of look like they're going down a little bit. Okay guys, I'm running late. I gotta go. I'll see you in another couple weeks. Let you know how it's going. Bye, handsome.
He's a good boy. You kept it on again. So it's been about a month. Good boy.
Okay guys, here's the biggest testament. Now, when I had the old muzzle, Buck would run away from me when he saw me with the halter, thinking I'd probably be putting that muzzle on. Here he is, out in the open and free. And he lets me walk right up to him. I do always give him cookies. But I can catch him. No problemo. Let's see if I can do this one-handed. Hang on, Harry. There we go. Sorry, didn't mean to drop you guys, but as you can see, no problem catching. It's been about a month. He's been wearing it like 12-ish hours at a time for about 5-ish days a week or so, and I will show you our after results. So as you can tell, he's still a chunky monkey. He'll always be a chunky monkey, but you can see a little bit of contour in his flank, whereas before, that was just like totally bowed out. So that looks a lot better, huh? You're not such a balloon. You can actually see his hips on both sides, whereas before his belly was so bubbled out you could hardly see his hips when looking straight on. He never really had a crusty neck, but I do feel like his neck's a little more streamlined now. And I think the biggest difference is actually from his behind. So his behind was like bubbled out a lot. And he's still, a lot of this is muscle though, but I'm thoroughly impressed with it for using it only a month. And we're coming into the fall grass, so I can't wait to see how he does this fall.